All right, guys, today we are expanding out our tree wells for our fruit trees in the front yard. So we have here is our little dwarf multiple variety plum tree. We got quite a bit of new growth on it this year. Just put it in this spring in about March, and here at June we're already looking at anywhere from 12 to 20 inches depending on the leader of new growth. So not too bad. And we started out with just a little bit of a tree well covered up with the heavy mulch that we do, wood chips, the back to Eden style gardening method here. And it was just a really small layer. It was really quick. I only had so much wood chips available to me. So today we're gonna turn this into this. Much wider at the base, probably got about 2.5 feet on either side, and we're actually looking at about 10 inches all the way around. And so this one here is our apple tree, not as much new growth, but still pretty good. And then we have our cherry tree over there. Now, I did it first is I took my my trimmer, I got a stick trimmer, and made a groove in the ground. Just took it about 2.5 feet on either side, just run around until all that grass is out, and made a nice little round, a good circle all the way around there, so I could use that to visualize and see without using my shovel, because I can't do it, you know, with a shovel each piece at a time. And so I made a circle all the way around it, and then I took my little flat-headed small shovel here, and I took it, and all the way around I just kind of took it and cut into the sod so it was cut down. And then from there I just take and shove underneath, pry up a little bit, shove underneath, pry up a little bit until I get about a shovel length, and then I cut it off. Same thing, just take it, cut it through, and then pull that piece of sod out. So I'm going to do that a few more times and show you as I go along. So there it is, all the sod's cut out, and taking a look at it, it's not perfect, it's not perfectly round, but honestly I'm not going for perfection. Eventually this entire front yard is probably just going to be wood chips anyway. There's no need for me to have grass, doesn't give me anything, doesn't feed me, just takes work. And so anyway, so that's that. Now we're going to go over to our handy little pile of wood chips over there, load up the wheelbarrow, spread it on out, keep it nice and even, and go on from there. So this usually takes me about 2.5 wheelbarrow full of wood chips to get what I was getting with the cherry and the apple tree. So I'm going to do one more and another half, load it up on top, smooth it out with my hands,
until it's nice and level, keeping a nice edge from the wood chips to the grass that I can take my trimmer to and keep that edge nice and clean so the grass doesn't start growing into the wood chips, because as soon as it does, it likes to take off just because of the environment that it's in. So if I can maintain that by keeping that edge, and it just looks really nice. Try to keep the neighbors happy for as long as possible while I have a yard, because as soon as I turn my entire front yard into a wood chipped garden, they may not love the aesthetic appeal that it brings. So anyway, that's how I extend out my tree well for my fruit trees in the front yard. I'm not saying it's the best way or the way that you should do it, but it's the way that I do it, and worked pretty well for me. Just a little bit of work trying to get that sod up, and that's about it. And a lot of people might ask, you know, why take the grass out? I know Paul Gauci would say leave the grass there, because as it dies, it'll become nutrients for the tree that it was close to. Personally, I agree with that absolutely, but I don't want to put cardboard down and have to cut it to shape and get it to look nice and deal with all of that. I'd much rather, you know, cut out my circle with the trimmer, know my line, cut that out, cut the sod out with a shovel, and just go straight to the dirt, put the wood chips on the dirt, having it look nice and clean. And the nutrients are still going to get there through the wood chips as they start to break down. And, you know, I make my compost tea, put it on there too. So I'm not too worried about a little bit of dead grass being taken out. So there you go. Hope you enjoyed. Hope it helped with whatever you're looking for. And hope you were entertained. All right. We'll see you guys later.